Goodness, thank you very much for having me. I just gained full knowledge about a lot of information. Thank you very much for seeing all of you. My name is Dilkhwaz Ahmed. I'm Executive Director of License to Freedom. License to Freedom is a community-based organization committed to work with the refugee and immigrant communities by providing domestic violence education, prevention, treatment, and also promote social justice. Part of our work, we deal a lot with issues of civil engagement. We try to engage the refugee community to be part of the community, to be part of the solution rather than being part of the problem. So today I was asked to represent a Kurdish community. Although in my job, I'm an activist, I'm a woman, I'm an immigrant, and number four, I'm Kurdish. So in my job, I represent all of the community because my clients are coming from all of the countries, so I cannot represent only, I cannot put myself in the box. But today, just, you know, briefly, I would like to talk to you about who are the Kurdish. Kurdish are a population estimated among 30 million. They are one of the largest group without a proper nation or state. Their traditional homeland is Kurdistan. It was forcibly broken through the centuries of political turmoil in the Middle East. The land was once Kurdistan is currently divided along the border of Iran, Turkey, Iraq, and Syria. So the Kurdish people between 1965, even before I was born, my mom always used to tell me, we were in war until 2003. But we've been betrayed by United States for history. Between 1986 to 1988, 180 Kurdish people been genocide, and nobody talk about it. We've been betrayed. So that led the Kurdish to be in a long, long, term with a fight with the regime of Saddam Hussein and the Iraqi regime. So those people, because of they've been persecuted, so they have to escape and go to Iran or some other country to seek political asylum and being refugee and come to United States. So between 1965 until 2002, we have a lot of Kurdish. We don't know how many Kurdish we have. This election is very, very important for us. Why it's important? Because we know, now somebody tell me, do you have a lot of Kurdish in San Diego? We do have, but we don't know how many. So the most biggest Kurdish population are in Nashville and in San Diego and in Washington, D.C., and they are everywhere. But the problem, we don't know how many Kurdish lives here in the United States. That will be so important so we can have enough influence on the congressional election. When I ask Kurdish people, what is this 2020 U.S. Census about? The answer is always, it's about self-identity. Because we are Kurdish, we are not Arab, you know? And most of the time, people put us in the Arab category, but we are not Arab. So when I ask them, we're so thankful that, and we're happy for the first time that the U.S. Census will include right and option, which enable Kurdish people to identify their ethnic minority group as a Kurdish. So why it's very important for me to influence the Iraqi, the Afghan, the refugee, the immigrant community? We live in San Diego. I live in a city of El Cajon. We have only the city of El Cajon, we have 35,000 Iraqis. And when you look at the data, when the county represent, do you know how many? We are 8% in El Cajon. We are more than 55%, but they don't want to show this number. Second, during the redistricting, when we went to the city of El Cajon, the Iraqi community, the Afghan community, we were lining inside the city council and outside. We were advocating for some particular mapping, but because the city of El Cajon, it's full of refugee, but run by white people, they had to vote for what is important for them. The school around city of El Cajon, the school board, they're all white people. We have a lot of issues of discrimination, racism, especially when the Syrian community arrive. There are a lot of issues of school, bullying, and the school, they don't wanna adopt any bullying policy. Why? Because we don't have a representative there. So nobody can advocate. So this is very important for us as a Kurdish community, as a refugee, as an immigrant. That's why we work so close with PANA. We were able to translate those flyers to many, many languages through Facebook, through Skype, through Viber. We are so active through Viber. So we send information through Vibers to the community, and the community, they have questions, they answer us. And because we work so close with PANA, we were able to do a lot of phone calls and reach out to the community, Arab, Afghan, Kurdish, Chaldean community, and encourage them to be counted, because it's very, very important. It's our voice, it's our future. We need to bring school. We need to bring new school. We need to bring interpreters to court. To me, I remember when I went to LA three times to help one of our clients. It happened to move from LA to San Diego, but the case was still there. We went four times. Every time they would bring some interpreter, they didn't know who the Kurdish are. The client was Kurdish, and she was my only Kurdish client that happened to be in LA. So one time they brought us a Persian, one time they brought us an Arabic, third time they brought us a Turkish. They say, what's the difference? So that's why it's important. It's important because it's about future of our client, of our community. We need a brighter community, better future. If it doesn't work for me, I rather to work for our kids. That's why we advocating in that area, and we work so close with the refugee community here. We encourage them to fill out the form and be counting and be counted and be part of the process. It's time for us. Like, it's, we sick and tired to be called immigrant, refugee, voiceless. We are taxpayer. We are contributing. Even people who are in the welfare system, they say they are not contributing. They are bringing a beautiful culture. When Syrian community arrived to our city, they brought family oriented. They brought a beauty, safety to our community. So everybody bringing something, because we are very important. We want to be counted. We want to be on the city council. We want to be on board. We want to be on the school board. We want to be on the Congress. We want to be on the Senate. We want to be everywhere. We are a better representative. And you know what? The rate of crime in the refugee community is way, way, way lower.
Okay. So